Hello everyone. This is part 3 Java Game Graphics 2D tutorial. In this part we going make a player can move and shot. Now we go to player class. And create variable max speed as final value and set it 1. And variable speed as 0. Then we need create one more variable is speed up as boolean. So we use this boolean to check condition for draw image. Next we create two methods speed down and speed up to change player image. Now go to panel game class. In method init keyboard and in while loop thread. We check condition when user press key space. So when user press key space we call method speed up in player class. And if user do not press key space or release key space we call method speed down. Now we can see the image of player has changed when I pressed key space. Now we need to make the player move to next. Go to player class. Create method update and change variable x and y by using math sin and cos. In method speed up we increase variable speed and method speed down we decrease variable speed. Now go to panel game class and call method player.update. Let run the project. So we see the player is move when I pressed key space. Next we going to make a player can shot. By create new class call bullet in package game object. Create variable x and y to store the location of bullet. And shape object to store a bullet as a shape. Color as color of bullet and set it to white color. Variable angle is angle of the player has shot. Bullet size and speed of bullet. Next create constructor and initialize to location x, y, angle, size and speed. We need calculate the location of player to location of bullet. And initialize value to all variable. And for shape object we initialize with ellipse 2D to make it as a circle. Next create method update to move location of the bullet. Create method draw to render a graphics. Create affine transform to capture default transform option from graphic. Call g2.translate to location x and y. Then draw the shape of bullet. And the last, we set old transform option that we has captured to make it to default. Next we create getter method. And method get center x and y of the bullet. And method check to check when the bullet has moved outside of the screen. This method will return false when it has out of screen. Next go to panel game class. Create bullet object as a list of collection. And shot time to store the duration when user press key shot. Now go create method init bullet. And initialize bullet list with array list class. Create thread to run the process of bullet. In this thread we use while loop. And sleep 1 millisecond. Then use for loop to make all bullet in list collection is moving. Call method update in class bullet to increase the location or make the bullet is moving. And check the bullet if move outside of the screen by call method check. If the check method return false, we need to remove bullet object from the list. And also remove bullet object is it null. Then call the method init bullet. Next go to method init keyboard in thread process. And check if user pressed key J and key K. Then check if variable shot time equals 0. We add new bullet object to list. Set angle of bullet as angle of player. For key J we set the bullet size as 5 and for key K we set the bullet size as 20. And the speed are 3. So when the user stop press key shot we reset the shot time to 0. And if the user keep press shot we increase shot time variable with plus 1. And if variable sort time equal 15 we reset shot time to 0. Next go to method draw game to render bullet graphics. Using for loop to loop all bullet from list and call method draw to render graphics. Let run the project. And thank you everyone for watching. See you next video.